creates dreams. Walls move, minds do too.
On a warm San Francisco night, old child, young child, feel alright. On a warm San Francisco night, angels sing, leather wings, chains of blue.
Hey, sorry, do you mind if I sit here while I wait for my coffee?
Oh, yeah, knock yourself out.
Oh, oh my gosh, I'm so sorry.
No, don't worry, it only spilled
I'm
a little.
I'm such a klutz. Ugh. Is your sketchbook okay?
Yeah, unscathed. It's just doodles anyway.
Can I see it?
Oh,
Oh, this is a cool castle.
Thanks. I just started drawing again. I used to sketch constantly, and then, I don't know, I just stopped.
So did I. I mean, there was a time in elementary school when I was the girl who was good at drawing.
The girl who was good at drawing? I remember that girl.
Everyone was always like, oh, please, will you help me with my poster?
How do I draw hands?
Exactly. I was like, I don't know how to draw hands. I'm 5 years old.
Well, let's see how far you've come since your toddler years.
Okay.
You're drawing in it upside down.
Hey, there is no right or wrong way to draw in a sketchbook.
Okay, that's fair.
Oh, wow, that's my order. That was fast. I'm Kenzie, by the way.
I'm Michael.
It's nice to meet you. I just gotta run.
Bye, Kenzie. Now this takes me back. Welcome to the fair.
Not how I pictured it.
What did you imagine?
You saw my drawing, you know, circus tents and stuff.
Well, a county fair is nothing like a circus.
I know, but I don't know. I just kind of assumed.
Hold on, your parents never took you to the fair?
No, we went to Disneyland.
Oh, you are gonna have to set your bar 1,000 times lower. Think like a farm, but with a lot more deep fried stuff. And tube tops. And $20 beers.
Will they at least have a Ferris wheel?
Okay, yeah, that is the one thing you sketched that we probably will see here. But it won't look like the janky one you drew.
Really?
No, it will be even jankier. I mean, these rides, they're death traps, and that's all part of the thrill.
Tube tops, $20 beers, and death traps? That's setting the bar plenty high for me.
Thank you.
Ooh, you want to try this fortune-telling machine?
I don't know.
What, you don't like these?
I'm not superstitious, but if I get a bad fortune, I feel like it's some kind of doomed, self-fulfilling prophecy.
These things don't give bad fortunes.
Not necessarily. When I was a kid, one of those things told me my pet turtle Pinky would die, and she did.
Well, unfortunately, that is part of the turtle life cycle. They do die.
It was a Galapagos turtle.
No, it wasn't.
No, but she did die a few days later.
Okay, we don't have to do it.
No. Just because I don't want to do it doesn't mean you shouldn't. Go for it.
Okay.
What does it say?
Nothing.
Michael?
I guess they do give bad fortunes sometimes.
Huh.
Yeah, you were right.
Here it is.
Wow, this place is great.
Isn't it?
What do you call it?
Just the secret spot, I guess.
I've walked past here a million times. I never knew this was here.
I don't think anyone does.
Wow, you can see the street from here.
Yeah.
They have no idea we're up here.
You do know what the word secret means, right?
Oh, come on. You don't think anyone knows about this?
No, I put that little guardian owl in there.
Oh, so he keeps it safe?
No, dude, he's made of wood. I just think he'd be gone or vandalized if anyone else had been here. I really think I'm the only one who knows.
Well, no, two people know.
I've never shown this place to anyone, Michael. You're the first.
I won't tell anyone.
Promise?
Pinky promise.
Okay, I need to run to work. You've got the address for tonight?
Yeah. When should I get there?
Well, my roommates are kicking things off at 7, but my shift isn't done till 9. But if Aaron shows up, I can get out at...
So what time should I get there?
Get there when you get there. If I'm not there, just introduce yourself.
Great. I'll see you then.
There you are.
Hey.
How long have you been here?
I was just about to ask you the same.
Who are you talking to?
One of your friends, tall, pale, heavy eyeliner.
Guy or girl?
Girl.
Oh, Anne. She's not my friend. She's a friend of a friend.
But still a friend.
Oh, yeah. Love her. But I want to introduce you to my really close friends.
Well, Anne gave me a whirlwind tour of introductions already.
Oh?
Yeah, and they all knew who I was.
Oh.
Yeah, I am, quote-unquote, Kenzie's bestie. Your roommate Tom actually insisted that I have been your coworker for 2 years.
Oh my God, Michael, I'm so sorry. That's so embarrassing.
Kenzie, I am not good with... Can we go somewhere to talk?
Yeah, my room's down here.
You know, I'm not good with things like making moves or whatever, but I didn't think that... We're not just friends, are we?
Michael, look, I'm not good with making moves either. I mean, I'm way better than you, but these last couple weeks, honestly, I feel like I'm in a dream pretty much the entire time I'm around you. And no, we're not just friends.
Sing so many things and yet I stall. My ears ring as I climb hills to see them all in Dolores Park, watching fireworks sparks fall.
What?
I think I love you.
You think?
Yeah, I mean, yeah.
what do I say back?
You can say, I love you too.
Well, you didn't say I love you. You said, I think I love you. And you want me to just straight up say I love you back?
You don't have to do anything.
You are trapping me.
I'm not trapping you. I'm expressing my feelings.
With a qualification.
Michael, I'm just saying that I think...
You think.
What
again.
Do you want me to say?
You don't have to say anything. I don't want you to say something that you are not ready to say.
But I do want to say it. Okay.
I love you, Kenzie.
I love you too, Michael.
Hello, sunflower.
Hey.
You know what I want?
What?
A landscape fridge.
I don't know what that is.
I just invented it. You know refrigerators? They are tall and narrow, so there's this bottom shelf of stuff that you have to bend down to and pick through to see what's there, and so you never do. It's horrible.
Chilling.
Ha! But imagine a fridge, same size overall, but countertop height, laid out horizontally, everything is accessible. Right there. No bending down.
You nerd.
It makes sense though, right?
Yeah, but where the hell are you gonna put it? It's not gonna fit in our kitchen.
Hey, this is our dream kitchen.
Oh, well, you know what I want?
What?
A dream house to go with this supposed dream kitchen of yours.
Well, duh.
No, but you know what I've always really wanted?
Hmm.
A grandfather clock.
Yeah, but those things are loud. I mean, they're totally impractical for a place in the city.
Yeah, but I always pictured settling down somewhere outside of the city.
Oh, really?
On a few acres near some woods, quiet and out of the way, where it snows in the winter, but not too much.
Uh-huh.
A big tree in the yard.
Wait, okay, can you throw in a few more cliches there, like maybe a picket fence and a dog and a cat? Oh, maybe 2.5 kids?
Hey, this is a dream house, remember?
I know.
But yeah, I like that, a dog and a cat. Michael.
That was a nice ceremony.
Yeah, I liked the giant goblet they drank out of.
I'm glad she didn't have a veil.
Why?
I just feel like the veil, the death do us part, it feels very haunted, very ghosty.
I like ghosts. I'm actually very excited to be one.
Ooh, when you die, where do you want to haunt?
When I die?
Yeah, when you're a ghost, where do you want to haunt?
I guess I want to zoom over the ocean really fast.
Really? Which part of the ocean?
The whole ocean. I just want to zip around with my arms spread out. I don't want to haunt anyone in particular. Just the whole sea.
Ah, scaring sea creatures and seagulls. Interesting choice.
Where do you want to haunt?
Well, if I die before you, I would want to haunt you.
Are you going to try and scare me?
Oh, I'm going to spill your coffee all the time just to remind you of me.
You dead and no coffee. My worst nightmare.
Oh, really? Is that your worst nightmare?
Michael?
Well?
I honestly don't know what I'd do without coffee. Weird right now.
Doing what? Painting a painting together?
Painting a painting together in a public park while drinking wine.
Not at all. I'm sure a lot of famous artists did exactly this. And who knows, maybe in this very spot.
Oh, we should probably get going. Holly's 4th of July parties are not to be missed.
Oh yeah, good point. Yeah, let's wrap this up.
What?
I mean, I'm looking forward to the party, but I don't want this to end.
Me neither.
Could we just not go, stay in the park and keep painting?
Yeah.
I mean, this is like the best day I've ever had.
Me too.
Why end it just for some party?
Let's not let this end.
Text Holly. She'll understand.
I love you, Michael.
I love you, Kenzie.
Hello, Sunflower.
Oh, good, you got beer. Thanks, hon.
Yep, decided to live a little on a weeknight.
How was school?
Great. No. It was boring. Want to watch a movie tonight?
Do you want to keep watching that trashy show we were watching last week? What was it?
Yeah, sounds good. Hello, Sunflower.
Hey, I got wine. It's on the counter.
Why did you just snap your computer closed?
Because you just got home.
Okay. But you just snapped it shut like a kid hiding something from his mom.
I'm sorry. I'm trying to give you my full attention.
I mean, whatever you're doing is fine. I just don't like how you hid it from me.
I didn't hide anything from you.
Whatever, it's fine. You made stir fry?
Yeah.
What are you watching?
Just some trash. You're home kind of late.
I bought beer.
I put dinner in the fridge.
Oh, I...
Why didn't you text?
Sorry, it was a last minute thing.
And you didn't invite me?
I went out with Angela.
Oh.
I'm just trying to repair my friendship with her.
Okay. I mean, you still could have texted.
You're right. I'm sorry.
You want to watch something, or?
I'm just going to use my laptop in the other room.
Hey.
You have mail here. Oh, did you hear from your mom yet?
How was work?
I was at school tonight. Did you hear from your mom?
Yeah, how was school?
You totally don't care, do you?
What? I care.
Do you?
Yeah, I asked you how work was.
School.
School. Okay, how was your day, Kenzie? I was asking how your day was. Does it matter if it's work or school?
Apparently, it doesn't.
Oh, come on. Look, I'm sorry. I just...
Sorry for not caring?
No. Oh, no.
My weeks are tough. I'm working and I'm going to school. And I'm not saying your job isn't burning you out, but when I come home from a long day, a very long day, I would really appreciate it if you could give me just the tiniest bit of your attention.
Are we really going to start having this conversation again?
Yes. Yes, we are going to start this conversation again. We're going to start this conversation over and over again for infinity until we figure out how to end the conversation without you tuning out.
What is that supposed to mean?
It means whenever I want to have a discussion about something serious, you end up just leaving the room, mentally or physically. You refuse to deal.
I leave the room because when I tell you how I feel about something, you insist it's not how I really feel. What is the point in having a conversation if you're not going to believe what I say?
You hide, Michael. You hide your feelings from me and even from yourself.
Oh, and I'm the only one in this room that's guilty of that. Look, I know I'm not great with my feelings, but I try. You, on the other hand, you do anything you can to steer the conversation off of yourself and onto me.
Oh, how so?
How so? How so? I asked you 3 times how your day was today, and instead of reciprocating my effort...
But you weren't listening!
I was making an effort! I would much rather have a conversation about your day than be lectured about what days of the week you're at school.
What? How do you actually think this is about school or work?
It's not! You're saying I'm not listening and you're the one that's not listening.
Thank you.
best day I've ever had.
Me too. Hey.
Hey.
Here's your stuff. I think that should be everything.
I mostly just wanted my books.
They're all in there.
And here is yours.
Oh, wow, it's small.
Yeah, it's mostly little stuff.
Great, thank you so much.
How are you?
I'm good.
You said in your email you're moving?
Yeah, I got a new job on the East Coast. I'm excited to be closer to family.
That's great. Back to the land.
Thank you.
How are you?
I'm good.
You said in your email you're moving?
Yeah, I got a new job on the East Coast. I'm excited to be closer to family.
Well, that's great. Back to the land where you're the girl who's good at drawing. I'm proud of you.
Thanks, Michael. And thanks for this. Well, see you around, I guess.
Yeah, see you around.
Hey. I miss you.
I miss you too.
When I wake up in the morning, I'll make you some coffee. We'll lay about and let the day pass. I'll wipe your blood off the concrete, take you to the party. We'll drink until our brains black out. You've got yourself. So
creates dreams. Walls move, blinds do too.
On a warm San Francisco night. Old child, young child, feel alright. On a warm San Francisco night. Angel sings, leather wings, chains of blue. On a warm San Francisco night. Old angel, young angel, feel alright. On a warm San Francisco night. I wasn't born there, perhaps I'll die there. There's no place left to go. San Francisco. Thank you.
get you, or me to get in here. Though it sounds like fun, what a drag to be when we come down in our rocket ship. What a drag it shall be. What a drag it will be, girl, when we come down. You said you was gonna stay, but that was yesterday. A little play now run. What a drag it is when we come down in our rocket ship. What a drag it shall be. What a drag it'll be, girl, when we come down. Living life alone, nowhere's my home. Ain't got no flag, put on a green. Tend to stay out late, rock and roll is my daddy. Say life, pray. Until the moment I wake up.
Okay.
Thank you.
understand, understand.
Me too. You do know what the word secret means, right?